Today I want to provide a brief tutorial of presetting and validating torque using our Fab and RAF series of clutch controlled electric screwdrivers by Culver. Taking this Fab driver out of the box, my main focus is the torque adjusting nut here. Torque is increased by turning this clockwise. It is further compressing an internal spring under the clutch cover, and that's going to in turn increase your torque output. If I turn this counterclockwise, I have the reverse effect of decreasing my torque output. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to go ahead and use a calibrated torque tester, which is very important to use the proper device to validate the output torque you're seeing from your screwdriver. Going to go ahead and quickly do a rundown here to see what this is set at out of the box. And I'm getting about 5.45 inch pounds of output torque. Let's say I would like to slightly increase the amount of torque I'm getting. I'm going to go ahead, turn this a couple times into a clockwise position to increase. I'm going to go ahead and perform another rundown. And 6.15 is actually where I'm looking to be on my target torque. So I consider this driver set up and ready to be put into production. The only other step I want to take is making sure that the lockout cover, which is built in, is set so that the operator cannot manipulate after this is put into the work cell. Some other factors that you do need to consider when setting torque for clutch controlled screwdrivers is, if there's a controller involved, you always want to make sure that you have preset your ramp, the knobs on the left for slow start, and your speed control, the knobs on the right. And so you can see here, I want a relatively low speed that the driver is able to offer. So I actually have the dial set to about 2. If you wanted to open that up, you just turn this clockwise and the driver, when set at 10, will run at its full speed. This is very important to make sure that no changes are made to these knobs after the driver is put into service, because it does directly correlate to affecting the output torque. If you do make changes to the controller, you do want to make sure that you go back ahead and validate the output torque to make sure it's exactly what's needed for your application. I hope this helps. If you would like to view this product or others, please visit our website, www.culverusa.com, or send us a note, culver@culverusa.com. Thank you.